Hello, I'm Senator Randy Becker down here in Olympia at the end of week four. We have 10 more days of committee hearings. This session, I can't tell you how fast this session has gone. It feels like we're already in week 40. With the number of bills we've had in health care, we have over 100 bills in health care right now. There's no way that we can get to each and every one of those bills, because if you're going to pass something into law, you need to make sure that you've done your due diligence and it actually is going to do what you think it's going to do and have a positive effect. As you know, I'm chair of healthcare, so I focus on that a lot, but I'd like to change it up a little bit today. I'd like to talk about education a little bit. I'm on the higher education committee and have been since my day one here. For a number of years, I either served as ranking or vice chair on that committee. This year, I just asked to be a member of the committee, and I have a tuition bill that I'm signing on with Senator John Braun, and I think that it would be worth your while to take a look at that. We don't have a bill number yet, so I'm sorry for that. But it would create a way to look at tuition at a percentage of the median income and help not just one type of person, but all folks, regardless of income levels, et cetera. And the reaction we'll get when we drop it, I'm not sure. I would love your input because it is something that we have to address with tuition going up. While our children are graduating from high school in the second legislative district at 91%, only 19% of our kids are going on to college. So another thing that I've been working on and we're putting forward in the budget is to do a $300,000 study of the feasibility of getting a college in our district. Now, up until redistricting, we were the largest populated district in the state, yet we didn't have any college in our district. We do have Pierce College for the folks that live on Puyallup South Hill and those that have transportation there, that may work okay. We have some over in the Lacey area that still kids have to travel so far. So we need to have opportunities for our kids just as much as we have for other areas. When we're talking about transportation, as you know, the governor's talked about a cap and trade tax that can end up costing around $1.17 a gallon. Those are the figures that are thrown out, and we really don't have a hard fact on that. We in the Republican Party and talked about doing reforms, making sure that we're not wasting the taxpayers' money, that we're doing the things to make that department more accountable, more transparent and efficient to projects and getting more bang for the taxpayer dollar. I happen to believe that if we're building a project, and those of you living in Pierce County can relate to this, the Cross Bays Highway, and it's only started and it takes another 30 years to get complete, it just creates one choke point down to another choke point. So my philosophy is maybe not quite so many projects right away, but get them done 100% so we face those things. So the Republican or the Majority Coalition Caucus is working really hard constantly on the transportation packages. It's really neat. Every weekend I go home, I stay in my fifth wheel down here in the Olympia area so that I can only drive 15 minutes to work every day versus the round trip for me of 2.5 hours. And I always look at that extra 2 hours as study time down here in my fifth wheel at night. But I miss my husband all week, so this weekend he's coming down with my dog Cooper. He's a border collie, and we're gonna go for a walk around the lake and we're gonna do some things together and just relax, and then I'm gonna be fresh for next week and hear more bills in the healthcare, higher ed, and then of course I'm on Ways and Means, which is a financial committee, and that to me is a really interesting committee because you get into the nitty-gritty of what all of the policies do. That's it for this week. We'll talk to you next week, and have a great week, and don't hesitate to let people know about these videos, about the emails, and this is your government. This is your government, and the only way I know what you want me to do is by you communicating, and you do well at that, but keep it up. I appreciate it. Thanks.